Hello, everyone, and welcome to our second half program of VATV. We thank you very much for tuning in with us every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. VATV is the voice of Vietnamese Americans in the Greater Boston area. It is sponsored by VietAid, a Vietnamese American Initiative for Development. The first half, as I mentioned, is going to be in Vietnamese, and the second half is going to be in English. You can watch us live every Wednesday. If you have Comcast, please go on at channel 9. And if you happen to have RCN, please come on to channel 15. And you can also watch us on bnntv.org. And if you happen to miss any of our programs, it will be rebroadcast on Sunday at 5 p.m., Monday at 1 p.m., and Tuesday at 11 a.m. And to watch any of our TV shows at all, you can go to our home website, which is vid8.org, and we're actually on YouTube now also. And for today's special program, our special topic is going to be about legal services, and we're very honored and excited to have back my ex-anger, I haven't missed her for a very long time, and coming back now, she is our attorney. We welcome Ms. Tram Nguyen. Thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. Tell us about you're currently with the Greater Boston Legal Services.
Yes.
Tell us exactly what is Greater Boston Legal Services.
Greater Boston Legal Services is a program that provides legal services to low-income residents of Greater Boston. So we go from, you know, all the way up to Woburn, all the way down to Scituate. So it's just in the Greater Boston area. And we cover, we have certain units in there that specialize in different areas of law. But to qualify for our program, you have to make under 125% of the poverty line. So currently, I have a list for 2014. So if you are under, if you're one person, then you have to make under $14,000. If you're under two people, then it's 19,662. Three people, 24,737. So basically, if you make anywhere from $400 to $500 a week, you should qualify for our program. And as I mentioned, we have different areas of law. We have the employment law unit, family law, health and disability, housing, immigration, and welfare. And particularly, there are other special units: Asian Outreach Unit, Community Law, Elder Law, and Mental Health and Disability. And I'm a part of the Asian Outreach Unit. This unit, it started back in the 90s, and it helps specifically help residents in the Asian community. And we have three attorneys. I'm one of the three attorneys. Two of the other ones speak Cantonese and Mandarin, and I speak Vietnamese. So I'm in charge of, you know, different areas of law, but all of which has to relate to domestic violence. But we are also very fortunate to have a paralegal who speaks Vietnamese. Her name is Huong Phan, and she helps out. You know, there are cases that I can't take because of the high caseload, or there are just cases that have no relation to domestic violence, so I'll hand it over to her. Mm-hmm. And so when we talk about all of our units, I'm the only Vietnamese-speaking attorney in the organization. And so all the other attorneys, even though they don't speak Vietnamese, if you need help in any other language, mm-hmm. we can still help because we have interpreters who can come in. We have phone services, like interpreting phone services. Okay. And of course, the courtroom also provides interpreters for free mm-hmm. for people who are low income. So there are ways to work around it. So if I can't personally take a case, I can always refer out to another unit, okay. or we sometimes work in collaboration with one another, or we can also refer out also to other bars, like the pro bono bar. And so we try to, even if we can't help someone with all of their problems, we try to help in whatever way we can. So we just suggest that people call us and, you know, let us know what your problem is, mm-hmm. and we can try to see where we can make it better.
Mm-hmm. So if someone have like a general question regarding about the services, do you suggest that they go specifically into a website, or they can call your assistant?
If you need assistance in Vietnamese, she does intake every every Tuesday from 2 to 4 at VATV.
Okay.
And so if you have any general questions, because if she can't answer it specifically, she always brings the case back to cases back to our office, and either myself or any of the other attorneys will probably give input as to, oh, this is what you should do, you know, please go ahead and do that. And so we work very well together. And so if you have any questions, if you need any help, I think the best way is to either go there or call our number.
Mm-hmm.
We have a general line that you can call. I mean, if you want to speak to someone specifically in Vietnamese, you can call my direct line, which is 617-603-1718. Or you can call the general line, which is 617-371-1234. Which again, 617-371-1234. This is for English-speaking clients, and if you don't speak English, they will have someone on the phone to try to identify what your language is and get an interpreter on the phone to try to help out your situation.
Mm-hmm. Talking about domestic violence, you probably, you know, you've seen this in all nationalities. If people are very hesitant to talk about their house problems or home problems. So how do you go about to get into the people to talk to you?
Right. We work a lot with organizations, especially Dorchester House. There's an advocate there that we work very closely with. Also, different shelters or police departments. If you know they come, someone calls 911. There's an issue in the house. The police department most likely will refer to an advocate. Mm-hmm. And if that advocate is Vietnamese, I've actually been very fortunate that the community is very supportive of my work. So whoever I've reached out to are very open to getting my information so that they can pass the information along. So, you know, and that goes across the board for other nationality, other groups as well. I think that a lot of people know about Greater Boston Legal Services. Mm-hmm. So even some of the police stations would just give you a card and say, call them.
Mm-hmm.
So I've gotten a lot of phone calls from that. But also word of mouth. I feel like since I've started here 8 months ago, so many people have come to my office and just say, oh, someone told me about you, and I don't know where, but they told me about it. And so, I mean, it feels good to get the word out there and let people know that, you know, there's free legal services. Mm-hmm. I mean, people always say, like, you know, if you don't have money, you can't win in court, but that's not always the case. Like, our attorneys, even though they work for the people for free, we are very dedicated to our work, and we want to help. And so we hope that, you know, people will utilize our services.
Mm-hmm. Based on, you know, your experience and your knowledge, what are the reasons, you know, talk about the main reasons. Why would people not call the police or talk to someone about their husband beating them or having any violence at home?
Well, it's a big cultural issue. Speaking from the perspective of a Vietnamese person, I feel like maybe our generation, we are a little bit more sensitive to this. So we know, like, okay, if someone's yelling at me and calling me names, this is not right.
Mm-hmm.
But coming from a culture where, you know, it's not very uncommon for a man to hit his wife, to discipline her, you know, to just put her down. I think that a lot of people don't even realize that they are in domestic violence situations
mm-hmm.
until it's almost too late. Like, most of the time, the people who come to me are the people who are like, oh my gosh, he almost killed me. I called the police, and that's when they said, oh, I need to take you out of your home, put you in a shelter, and get you in touch with an attorney.
Mm-hmm.
But we can prevent that from happening if people realize that just calling names, pushing, mm-hmm. threatening, even like little things like, oh, I brought you to the US, so I will kick you back to Vietnam.
Mm-hmm.
That's threatening. That's like harmful mentally and emotionally to a person. And so abuse is not just physical abuse. People think of like, oh, okay, he has to lay a hand on me. But if he's throwing things at you,
mm-hmm.
even though he misses, that's still abuse
mm-hmm.
because that's assault right there. Mm-hmm. You know, he can actually get charged for like assaulting you. So I think that people just have to be more cognizant and aware of the fact that abuse and violence encompasses a lot more than just physical abuse. So we have verbal abuse, we have sexual abuse, as in if you are a person, you do not want sexual advances, and you know, even if it's your husband or wife, mm-hmm. that's sexual abuse. Mm-hmm. It's against your own will, and people need to realize that. And I think that's number one reason why a lot of people don't call. The other reason is that for, embarrassment. Mm-hmm. I feel like in the Vietnamese culture, no one wants to be like, hey, I'm mm-hmm. a victim. You know, my husband or wife abuses me, and I think that this is why they don't come to us. And the third reason is privacy concerns. Like, mm-hmm. no one wants to know, like, air their dirty laundry, you know what I mean? So that's why I want to emphasize the fact that our services, like, I am the person's attorney. Attorney-client privilege, confidentiality, we value that very highly. Everything that's said in my office stays in my office. It stays within the relationship of the client, the attorney-client relationship. And we just want to emphasize that, you know, things that are said to us will not be disclosed unless mandated by law, unless you tell me I killed someone. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, anything else that I'm mandated to disclose. But for the most part, most of what is said will be kept confidential, and, you know, things will stay within, and whatever they feel comfortable with. We respect mm-hmm. the client's decision. So if they come to me and they tell me all their story, but then they're like, I really don't want to go through with it. Mm-hmm. There's nothing I can do, and I won't force them to go through with it.
Okay. You know, with your clients, or I call them the victims, if I notice a case, can I contact you, or that person has to contact you?
You can contact me initially, mm-hmm. but I'd always have to get the client, because uh-huh. I can't help a person if they don't want to be helped. Mm. So, I mean, I've had cases where people call in and say, you know, I know someone who needs your help, mm-hmm. hesitant to talk to you. You know, I'll just explain the process, but I can't really go into the case mm-hmm. unless I talk to the client, mm-hmm. because I need that relationship and I need that trust mm-hmm. in order to go forward with the case. Mm-hmm.
So, Tram, what can we do to have, victims or clients basically be open up more to, you know, to say that this is okay. It's okay to talk to someone. It's okay to reach, an attorney mm-hmm, because due to domestic violence. What can we do?
Well, I think that number one is education. I think that a lot of people stay in relationships mm-hmm. for a variety of reasons, but I feel like a lot of new immigrants, especially, they want to stay in the relationship because they don't want to be kicked out of the country, which is a false impression, because a big part of my project is to help women or men, victims of domestic violence, who they married in another country, particularly Vietnam. They come over here with their new husband or wife, and the husband or wife abuses them, and they're like, well, I'm gonna stay here so I can, you know, once my conditional 2-year green card is over, then, you know, maybe I can leave him. But in the 2 years, a lot could happen. Mm-hmm. You know, if the guy's very abusive, you don't want to stay with him even a second longer. And I think that they need to just be aware that there are services, there are ways for them to get out of that relationship without, you know, being kicked back to Vietnam. Or a lot of women also are afraid of losing their children because a lot of them, a lot of the abusers always claim that, oh, I know English, I know the law, you don't, so you're gonna lose. Well, you know what, that's not the case, because the law is the law. Most of the time they don't really know the law. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And secondly, even if they don't know English, we have interpreters and we can certainly help them. The other thing is to just, again, emphasize that it's confidential. Like, we really want to emphasize to people that just because you're coming to us doesn't mean everyone will know your business. Your business is your business, and we think that that as long as they understand that, mm-hmm. that we will help them in private. I think more people will come out. Mm-hmm. And also, not just domestic violence. I think there's so many other areas of law that we can help people with. Like, they should just come to us with basically any legal issue. And, I mean, if we can't help, and then we can't help. Mm-hmm. But, like, most low-income people, they don't have a lot of assets. They don't have a lot of things. So most of their problems are problems that we can certainly help with. Mm-hmm. So going back to your question, it's networking. I'm currently networking, I'm outreaching to different community members, to domestic violence advocates all over. Just if they come in contact with someone who deals with, who is a victim of domestic violence, I hope that they will send them my way.
Mm-hmm. Great. Now, if they reach you and they, you know, doesn't want to come into your office for any reasons, to the public, seeing them, things like that, would you meet them like at the home or somewhere private?
I wouldn't do that at the home, just mm-hmm. because I don't know the mm-hmm. for safety concerns. Yes. But I have gone to VATV if I have an appointment with a person, if they can't make it to my office. But mostly my office is the best way because it's private. Mm. I can ensure that there's safety, like if the perpetrators are following them or whatnot. We have security. And also, all the paperwork is there. I don't need to scramble to find all the paperwork. So I think it's best. But we're very, very easily accessible by T. There's also parking, but the parking lots are pretty expensive downtown. But we're right at North Station. So we're a two-minute walk from North Station. So people can easily come to us. I've been on the phone with people showing them how to get there. Mm-hmm. So we try to help whenever we can. But I mean, if they really can't come, mm-hmm. I can certainly meet them in, VATV or I think VATV is the only other place I would do it because we have a privacy room. Like I wouldn't meet them anywhere, mm-hmm. In public because I wouldn't want all their information out mm-hmm. in public.
Okay. This is such a huge topic regarding about domestic violence. And when you say, I mean, I've seen it before, and I've seen where couples just fight, and then the next day, everything is okay.
Yeah.
So now, if you happen to call, the client happened to call you, and then you're doing all the paperwork, filing against the husband or wife, who knows, right? And then they decide to change their mind. What happened in the process?
That doesn't really happen too much to us since most of the people who come to us, they are in very, very bad situations mm. where they no longer live in the home. Mm. And so we've had a few cases where people come to me mm. and say they want to do a divorce and then in the middle, they rekindle. But that really doesn't happen very often, mainly because people come when they really have nowhere else to go.
Okay. Like you mentioned earlier that the husband or the wife could be just saying something, really bad to you, and it's harming you mentally.
Right.
Now, after you talk to the client and things like that, do you help them all the way with the process of sending them to another department for help with those challenges?
Well, it's tough because most of the time we don't win cases where it's just mental abuse. Mm. That's the problem. If you think about it, mental abuse is always coupled with more. Mm. There's rarely ever any case where the guy's just yelling. Mm. There's always some action that goes with it. Mm. So, and it really depends. Like, if we can take the case, we'll take it. We have other, we collaborate with the Volunteers Lawyers Project. They do pro bono work. Mm-hmm. And so they actually, they're the opposite of us. So if you need a divorce and there's no domestic violence, mm-hmm. then we send it to them.
Okay.
And mental abuse, since there are no domestic violence, so okay. we will send that to them. Mm-hmm. We also work with other organizations like the Family Law Unit. And we try to refer to them or work with them whenever we can. Mm-hmm.
Well, we want to thank you so much for your time.
Oh, it's up already?
Yes. This topic is very broad, and I'm sure that, you probably have a lot of questions for Attorney Tram Nguyen. So please give her a call, 617-371-1234.
That's the main number.
Okay.
Or you can call me directly at 617-603-1718.
Okay. One more time for that.
617-603-1718.
And of course, you can certainly come to VATV from Monday through Friday. Attorney Tram assistant is going to be there from Monday through Friday from 2 to 4 p.m. So you come there if you have any questions at all, any general questions, any inquiries. But we want to thank you so much again for being here with us today. We're definitely going to invite you back here to talk more about the program, especially the Greater Boston Legal Services. There's so much to cover. So once again, we want to thank you, everyone, for watching us tonight. And please, again, tune in with us at every Wednesday at 7 p.m. If you have any questions or anything at all, please email to us, which is at vatv@v8.org, or you can call us directly at 617-822-3717. Again, we thank you very much for your time. Have a good night. Thank you.